Good morning. Merry Christmas. I trust that you woke up like really early this morning and you did. So the Carroll family woke up really early, huh? Yeah. We're so glad that every 7 years Christmas falls on Sunday. I'm glad it only happens once every 7 years. But, I mean, it is Christmas, and I'm glad that you're here gathered together. Thank you so much. We have families and guests and just the regular CCBC family gathered together in this place. And it's a great joy to just be here together. What better place to be than to be in church, worshiping the Lord together, acknowledging why we have Christmas. And so thank you for it. So for the next hour, we're just going to sing together and hear some scriptures and just a couple devotional thoughts. And then at 11 o'clock, at noon, we'll be done. You go home, have your dinner, take a nap, watch football, open presents, take a nap, eat, take a nap, and eat some more. That pretty much sums up the day, right? All right, let me have a prayer, and then Kevin's going to read some scripture. Father, thank you for this day of worship. And God, it's a day of joy. Help us, Lord, to see that in the kind of world in which we live in, the message of Christ is a message of joy. And thank you for gathering us together in this place on the Lord's Day, on this day that we recognize as Christmas. In Jesus' name, amen.
Matthew 2, 1 through 6. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all of Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem, in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people, Israel."
We're going to sing a Christmas carol that I don't think I've ever sung in church before. However, we all know the song. It's not in our hymnal. It's not in the previous hymnal. And I don't know why it's not. Because the words of this particular song, "God Rest You Merry Gentlemen," have probably the most biblical words, understandable words of all the Christmas carols. There are 7 verses to this song. We're going to sing all 7 verses. And each verse ends with a promise. And here's the promise: tidings of comfort and joy. Tidings of comfort and joy. We live in a society, we live in a world where those messages of comfort and joy are very much needed. Do you need comfort today? Comfort is found in Jesus. Do you need joy today? That joy is found through knowing Jesus Christ. So let's stand together, and we're going to sing this in sort of a contemporary style, where we've combined together both of our services and our Hispanic and our Japanese. We're all gathered together today. So let's sing this together. And Luke Richardson, welcome back from college.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, dismay. Remember, Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Blessed babe was born, and there within a this blessed morn. The witch's mother Mary did nothing take in scorn. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. From God our Heavenly Father a blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same. How that in Bethlehem was born a Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Born a Savior of pure and virgin bride, to free all those who trust in Him from Satan's power and might. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. The shepherds at those tidings rejoiced in much in mind, and left their flocks a-feeding in tempest, storms, and wind, and went to Bethlehem straightway a blessed babe to find. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Secretly, and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go, make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I may too go and worship him." After they heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh.
We're singing together a song. One song we sing primarily in the 11 o'clock service. The other songs we sing it all the time. It's a song written by Paul Balash called The Offering, and I think you'll recognize this song. And then it's a medley of a lot of songs. So again, let's just stand together. Giving today an offering of yourself to the Lord. He's not so concerned about, you know, we talk about offerings, giving of material goods, although that's important, but the most important thing is, are you giving him your heart, your life, your very being, your future? You know, only God knows what's going to happen tomorrow. Aren't you glad that he knows, but we don't? Because if we knew what was going to happen tomorrow, some of us would want the time to stop right here and not to advance into tomorrow. But God, who knows all things and who loves us, leads us, guides us, protects us, provides for us in every way. Aren't you glad that's who Jesus is, the Christ of Christmas? That was kind of pathetic. Aren't you glad that the Christ of Christmas that we know is the one who meets our needs, who is there for the tomorrows? Amen. 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 You may be seated.
A su lugar.
Lord, thank you so much that as that song reminded us, as Jesus and Mary and Joseph, or Mary and Joseph came to Bethlehem and then Jesus was born, Scripture tells us that there was no room in any of the motels, hotels, the inns of the day. And so the Lord Jesus was born in a very humble place, that stable, that barn, and placed in that manger. And God, that story is told and retold because so many of us find that in our lives there is no room for Him. There's a place for Jesus on Sundays or during times of emergency, but God, help us, Lord, to see that giving Jesus first place in our life, our heart, our very being, is a moment by moment, day by day, year by year, process decision that we need to commit ourselves to. Thank you for that song and the reminder that Jesus is the eternal King, and we must give Him rule and reign in our lives. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
So up next, we have the kids that are going to come up and do a play. So if you're part of the play, come on up. Also, Mr. Lee. Gather around now, kids. It's time to decorate our tree. Do you guys know why we decorate the tree for Christmas? Go ahead and start grabbing decorations there.
Because it looks pretty?
So we can put presents under it?
To keep dads from watching sports all weekend.
Oh, that is funny, Mr. Lee. Yes, all those are really good reasons. But there is another reason. The tree and other things we decorate at Christmas have meanings and represent other things we should think about at Christmas time. For instance, the green of the tree. Its pure evergreen color of the tree remains green all year round, representing the everlasting love and hope to mankind. Greta, what do you think? Long ago, God promised a Savior to the world. The star was a sign of fulfillment of that promise.
Let's see, what about a candle? Do you kids know what that represents?
It symbolizes that Christ is the light of the world.
And when we see His great light, we are reminded of Him.
That's right!
Santa Claus represents generosity and goodwill we'll feel during the month of December, which is why it's a season of giving.
What do presents represent? They must mean something if everything else does.
That's right. Presents represent the gift that our Heavenly Father gave us, as it says in John 3:16. For God so loved the world, He gave His one and only Son.
It also represents the wise men who bowed before Jesus and presented Him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. We give gifts in the same spirit as them to show our gratitude and love towards each other.
What about a candy cane?
It means our parents are supposed to give us lots of yummy candy for Christmas!
No, quite. It represents the shepherd's crook, the crook of the shepherd's staff. It helped him bring back the stray sheep from the flock. The candy cane represents the symbol that we are our brother's keeper.
We're supposed to help one another, be kind to them, and help them see the hope we find in Jesus?
That is exactly what we're supposed to do. Look at the top of the tree. What do you see?
An angel!
The angel reminds us to proclaim the good news of our Savior's birth. This is how we are to share hope with those that are lost. We share with them all the good news we find in the Bible, that Jesus came for us as a baby so that one day he could give his life for us and we could be forgiven.
So each and everything we do and see at Christmas points to God and the gift he gave us?
That's right. Christmas isn't about the presents, the food, good times with family. It's about Jesus and the things we do at Christmas. We can be reminded of him, the hope he brings to us, and it provides us ways to share with that with others.
Which reminds me of one last symbol, the bell. Bells are used on sheep so that shepherds can always find them when they are lost. By listening for the sound of the bells, it symbolizes guidance and return, that no matter how far we stray from God, he will always find us and accept us back into his family.
Well, good job decorating the tree, kids. So why don't we go ahead and get ready before we have to get ready for lunch?
So then we can share all the traditions we have at the table. I can't wait.
Christmas isn't about the fun, the family, and fellowship. It's about Jesus and the promises that were fulfilled through his birth and the hope that we find in his life, death, and resurrection. Christ came for each and every one of you. And as you celebrate Christmas with your family, be reminded of each of these things and truly think about the message you display in your home. To close, the kids are going to sing a song for you.
Oh,
passage of scripture I've asked Adrian to read is not part of the traditional Christmas story. But as I was thinking about and putting together this morning's service, I was thinking, you know, Jesus is our example. I mean, he's our Savior, but he's our example. And what better passage? And he's also the focus of our worship. We worship him. We love him. We yield ourselves to him. And what better passage than Philippians? And so Adrian's going to read that passage from Philippians, which tells us who Jesus is.
Philippians 2, 5 to 11 says, "In your relationships with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father."
Together and sing. Scripture found also in the Gospels. We're going to read this passage together. It's found in Luke chapter 2. So let's just read these words together. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own towns to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed in the manger because there was no guest room available for them. We're going to sing two songs as we come to the close or near the close of our service. The thought that has been throughout the service today is to adore Him, to worship Him, to give our lives to Him. And so we're going to sing a song called Angels We Have Heard on High. And then we're going to sing a new song called Adore Him.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo, gloria. to Bethlehem and see in whose birth the angels sing. Come adore on bended knee, Christ the Lord, the newborn King. Heavenly child, adore him, adore him. This unlikely Savior who sings in the core, this tiny Messiah the prophets foretold. Come see the wonders your eyes will behold. Adore him, adore him. There is no other above or before him. Adore him, adore. Christ the Lord.
Let's do that verse again. This is a new song, but it reminds us of what we're doing, adoring Him.
Come to the manger and kneel at His side. Adore Him, adore Him. Come see Him sleep in this heavenly child. Adore Him, adore Him. This unlikely Savior who sleeps in the cold, this tiny Messiah the prophets foretold. Come see the wonders your eyes will behold. Adore Him, adore Him. There is no other above or before Him. Adore Him, adore Him. Come worship Christ the Lord. Adore Him, adore Him. You are the reason He willingly came. Adore Him, adore Him. Come and find peace, all ye restless and wild. Come, all you weary and unreconciled. Come just to gaze on this glorious child. Adore Him, adore. There is no other above or before Him. Adore Him, adore Him. Come worship Christ the Lord. Adore Him, adore Him. There is no other above or before Him. Adore Him, adore Him. Come worship Christ the Lord.
Going to give of our material goods as we come to the close of this service. God, you have blessed us, you've gathered us together, you've provided us with jobs and ways of earning income, you've blessed us with so much, and now out of hearts of love and adoration, we adore you, Lord. We declare that there is no other above you. There is no name higher, greater than the name of Jesus. Bless this offering as we give in His name. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you, ushers. trust you have a Merry Christmas today. Take a nap. Eat some cookies. We're going to do something a little bit different here as we close the service. I'd like for us to all stand and just join hands. Can we do that? We're together as a family. This is the Crossroad Community Baptist Church family. And if you're a guest today, hey, you're part of the family too. You guys, join hands up there on stage, okay? Everybody has a hand. Everybody, we don't want anybody to be a loner today. No one's a loner. In fact, in God's family, in God's economy, there are no orphans. There are no lone rangers. God loves you. God loves us without reservation. And you may be struggling, you may be hurting, you may be angry, you may be broken, you may be frustrated, you may be discouraged. What can you do with that? Bow before Him and worship Him. This song is called A Christmas Blessing. And I'm just going to sing the words. This is our church's and the Lord's blessing to you.
Merry Christmas, I wish you. May joy like snow fall daily new. May each day find love and truth and memories sweet. Merry Christmas, peace on earth. May Christ reveal your debt of worth. You are why He came to earth. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. From my heart to you. Merry Christmas, bless you, friend. May every wound find grace to mend. Daily strength renewed again by God's own hand. Merry Christmas, may you see the way God sees you and believe. His love and life abundantly. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. From our heart to you.
God bless you as you go.